So, welcome to the lecture series of Electronics Measurement and Instrumentation. In this lecture series, I am going to discuss about a different type of the printer. We know that printer is a most applicable instruments. It is in a modern era, it is one of the essential equipment, and almost all the household and offices, they use printers. So basically, printers are two types. One is called printers, and there are one more terminology that also use, that is called plotters. So basically, printer are character printer, or similarly they are graphic plotter. That in general we also called it is a printer, but actually it is the plotter. And there are the difference between the printer and plotter. But both this particular printer and plotter are the device used to prepare a permanent record of a computer output. Our printer or plotter are used to create a hard copy of a particular information. So if you want to create a hard copy of any computer output or any information, we require either the printer or graphic plotter. So printer or plotter are device used to prepare a permanent or hard copy of a computer output. And the basic difference between printer and plotter are, printer are the device which purpose is to print letter, numbers and similar character in text readable form. So it's a printer is able to print letters, numbers, characters in a text readable form, and the plotter is able to print diagram or continuous lines. So if you want to print some diagrams or some maps, then we actually required a plotter. But if you want to print only the letter, number and characters, then a printer is sufficient. So basically there are different type of the printer. So there are some broad category of the printer, and in each broad category there are different type of the printer. So first such category is impact and non-impact printer. So its name, it is clear, impact, it created some impact. So the character on the paper, by striking the paper with a print head and squeezing the ink ribbon between the print head and the paper. Actually, this type of, it is just like a typewriter. If you see the typewriter, a paper, if you see any typewriter, this particular typewriter consists of a paper, then a ribbon, and then there are a striking head. So this particular striking head strike the ribbon, and then this particular ribbon and head strike the paper, and then the character written in this ribbon head is printed on the paper. So it is called impact, because it create an impact. Similarly, a non-impact printer, it means character printed on the paper without engaging the print mechanism. For example, heating sanitized paper or by spraying the ink from a jet. If you are able to print the character on the paper, then it is called the non-impact printer. So I think you understand what is the impact factor and what is a non-impact printers. Sorry, impact printers and non-impact printers. Then there are a second type of the printer is called fully formed character and the dot matrix filter printer, sorry, not filter. So the fully formed character are like those made by a standard typewriter. If you see the typewriter, so all the character is available, 0 to 9, A to Z, all are available. So it is called a fully formed character. It all the character are embossed in a reverse on the type bars of the typewriter. When printed, all type element appear concerned, connected or fully formed. It means all this character is either the connected or it is separated. Similarly, the dot matrix printer character are saved by a combination of the dot that form a group representing a letter or number when viewed together. For example, if you're using a dot matrix printer to print a character that is named A, and if you magnify this particular A, what you observe that that particular A is created with due to a combination of the different dot. So that type of the printer is called the dot matrix printer. It is a similar printer that used at the railway station for print of the tickets. Similarly, it also used in the banks to print on the passbooks. So that type of the printer is called the dot matrix type of the printer. Then the character at a time and then character at a line. For example, if you want to print some letter, so there are two way possible. Either you print one character at a time or you print a line at a time. It means if, for example, my name is written JUGUL. So there is one possibility, either you first print J, then U, then G, then U, then L. So it is the character at a time. Then you print a small portion of J, small portion of U, small portion of G, then U, then L, J, U, G, U, L. And this small portion is added in each line. Are in each time interval. So in the first time interval we print one part, second part, then third time interval in third part. So it is a line by line printing. So first our pointer move from left to right and print some part of the character J U G U L. So these all the there are the five character and each part is printed. Then it's again move from right to left and then it start printing from left to right again one part similarly. So that is called the line by line printing, and second one is called character by character printing. So at the line at line printers print each line virtually instantaneously. Some advanced printer, that is those using laser and geographic methods, print lines so rapidly that they virtually print a page at a time, and therefore called page printers. So they are rarely used in mini computer and in micro computer for special purpose like phototype setting. So depending upon the application, you may use the character type of printing or you may use the line type of printing. But for the fast printing, we require a line type of printing. That is the overall the conclusion of this particular character at a time and line at a time printers. Then printer character sets, how they print. So the most printer use a microcomputer. This microcomputer is using basically ASCII codes. So a printer is specified as using 48 character set, then 64, 96, for just for development of the different modification of the printer. First it is able to print only 48 character, then 64, then 96, then 128. So 48 and 64 character set include commonly used special symbol, numbers, space, uppercase, English alphabet. But 96 ASCII character set include lowercase English. Here we use only uppercase, but lowercase is also added, alphabet and several additional special symbol. 96 characters space and delete do not print, leaving only 94 printable characters. Similarly, entire 128 character ASCII set contain 32 character normally used for communication and control. These characters usually do not print but corresponds to expendable functions such as communication and control. It means our 128 character set have almost all the printing capability, but all others have there are some limitation. But almost all our daily work is possible either by using the 98 set or character set or using the 64 character set printers. So that is all about a different printer set. Then Next is a character at a time impact printer or fully formed character. That is called a drum wheel type of printer. So basically the typewriter is a classic example of this printer, drum wheel type of the printer with character fully formed because they are embossed on each type bar. Actually this character is embedded in a reverse order in a bar. Ordinary typewriter cannot be used with computer because they lack a computer coding interface. Because the typewriter, we are able to print each character manually. So the classic printer used with mini and micro computer in the past was Teletype Model 33 printer. The ready availability and low cost of this printer plus their relatively easy interface made them natural for using small computer. The Model 33 printer is rate of 10 character per second, quite small speed in comparison to this modern generation printer, which is slow compared to the two-day printer of 55 character per second. The print mechanism is a vertical cylinder. See this particular diagram, a vertical cylinder, and all this particular cylinder, all the character is available in this vertical cylinder. Then there is the ribbon wire, there is a ribbon and then a paper. So ASCII character code sent to the printer in a printer is translated into motion. It means once whatever ASCII character is sent by the printer, then it creates a motion that rotate the cylinder. See this particular cylinder. This particular cylinder is rotated. This particular cylinder is rotated by the ASCII code sent by the printer. In the motion that rotate the cylinder, so that column containing the desired character face the paper. See here, all the character is printed on this. Once it move, so this particular character that is desired to print on the paper is in front of this particular ribbon and paper. So that when we created an impact, it will be printed on the paper. So the cylinder is then raised or lowered to present the column containing the desired character to be printed directly to the paper. A hammer mechanism propels the cylinder towards the paper where only the position character strike the ribbon, creating the printed impression of the character on the paper. These printer are interfaced with a small computer by 20 to 60 milliampere current used to transmit ASCII coded bit serially. So that is the one of the printer print mechanism that is actually called a drum wheel printer. So in the next lecture, I'm going to discuss about the Digi Wheel printers.